Imam Ahmad was one of the scholars of the time, like any other scholar. One of the scholars of the time. Why did he stand out? When he went through the trial of Khalq al-Quran, the claim that the Quran was created, he stood out. He said, no. They said, you're under torture. You have the excuse to say, to agree. Just save yourself. He said, no. And one day they brought him out. And they said, you just save yourself. They brought scholars, his friends. They told him, Allah has excused you. Why do you put yourself under so much pressure? You're about to die. You're about to be killed. They brought a paper for him and a pen to write and make the declaration that the Quran was created, which is a statement of disbelief. And they gathered the people, thousands of people, in one place. And when he looked and he saw all these people, he reclined. And he said a very beautiful thing. He said, أَمُوتُ وَلَا أُضِلُّ هَؤُلَاءَ. I die, I rather die than send these people astray. Was hardship. And he stood out until today. When we talk about Ahl al-Sunnah, the people, the true followers of the Prophet ﷺ, who hold on to the Sunnah of the Messenger ﷺ, we say, who is the Imam? That's his name, that's his title. Imam Ahmad, Imam Ahl al-Sunnah wa Jama'ah, until today. More than a thousand years have passed, and he is the Imam without any wife. It's through hardship. If this hardship didn't come his way, I don't think he would have really occupied this high position in the heritage of this Ummah and in the hearts of the Muslims. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through trials, He raises your rank in faith and iman, and He forgives you sins. So this is one of the wisdoms. And this is why the Prophet said that according to the level of your iman, you will be tried. You will be tried. Allah will remove your sins by that. The Messenger also says at the end of this hadith, وَلَا يَزَالُ الْبَلَاءُ فِي الْعَبْدِ حَتَّى يَذَرَهُ يَمْشِي عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مَا عَلَيْهِ قَطِيئًا. That trial will keep hitting the person, hitting the Muslim, until he walks on earth free of sin. You've done so much sin, Allah wants to purify you. Allah doesn't want you to be held, to be kept, to be held down and pulled down by that sin. So Allah sends trials your way so that your sins are forgiven and you rise up. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through trials, makes the true believers stand out. Because in the times of trial, the true believers stand out. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the verses we quoted, the verses that come after them, وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ نَافَقُوا. And Allah wants the hypocrites to become apparent. So the believers will stand out, and the hypocrites, the ones with weak faith, will be noticed as well. So we know who the true believers are. And Allah made the trials the way to this, to paradise. Because the nature of this world is that it's a time of trial. There is no absolute goodness, there's no absolute evil. You can never attain happiness in this world. Ultimate happiness, constant happiness, absolute happiness. Because that's not the world for happiness. And there's no ultimate misery in this world. It's a mixture of both. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept purity for the hereafter. So there will be ultimate happiness in paradise and ultimate misery and abyss in the hellfire. So the way to happiness, the eternal happiness, through enduring the hardships and the difficulties of this world.